God is the supplier of all of our needs. And as we celebrate tonight what it is that God does as Jehovah Jireh, who is our provider, there are two things that you need to know orally that God lets you know that you can live without. The first one that you can live without is your tonsils. You can live without your tonsils because as your vocal cords begin to expand, that's when you begin to feel a strain within your throat. And you must understand this, that whenever it is that you move to a new level in praise, that's when the devil will try to strangle the praise out of you. That's why when you're going through something, the enemy will tell you, stay at home. The enemy will tell you, it don't take all of that. I wish you would be quiet. I wish you would sit down. But you'll note this, that the people who don't want you to shout are the folk who don't need anything. But the folk who are desperate for God to do something awesome. They didn't come to church tonight to be on a video. They didn't come to be on the record. But they said, I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. And I think I got about 300 folk who just need God to do something. Oh, I'm talking about you need God to do something. The second thing that you can live without is your wisdom teeth. You can live without your wisdom teeth because wisdom teeth always show up late. And when they show up late, it disorganizes the entire dental structure because they try to move people and things out of the way that have already been established. You've got to be careful for folk who show up in your life late, who weren't there when you were struggling, who weren't there when you didn't know how to make it, who weren't there when you were trying to push and press your way. But God said, I planted you like a tree by the river. He says, when it is that you've lost your tonsils, when it is that you've lost your wisdom teeth, you're left with one thing. And the thing that you will not lose is your voice. Are you telling me, preacher, I can sing without my tonsils? I can shout without my wisdom teeth. But the only way that can happen is if I use my voice. And so if I can't sing like Smokey, I can still scream. And I want you to understand this, that the devil can't handle a screamer. Because you understand in the book of Isaiah, when it is that the devil lost his job as the leader of praise and worship, he was a trained musician. And because he was a trained musician, the devil knows how to sing on key. But whenever you sing, whether you're Luther Vandross or Patti LaBelle, you can never scream on key. So that's why you know when there's an imp sitting around you, because whenever you start screaming in church, they get an attitude. We can't go any further in this recording because there are some imps in the church. But I need some folk who are not afraid to just open your mouth and just scream. The only people who are screaming in this recording tonight are people who found out I can live without a man, that I can live without a car, I can live without money, but Jesus is all I need. If he's all you need, open your mouth and scream.
We're living in a day and time. We're being politically correct. It's popular. Let me turn that around again. We're living in a day and time where everybody's saying the name God, but nobody wants to say the name Jesus. We don't want to offend the Muslims. We don't want to offend the Jews. We don't want to offend the Arabs. And so therefore we crucify him of flesh. But I want you to know that there will come a time when every Muslim, when every Buddhist, when every Jew will have to get down on their knees and have to confess that every at the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow. So I want every blood-washed believer to not wait until then. And if you've ever gone through something, you know right here,
tell them
that there's something about the name.
Something, y'all.
Something about the name, Jesus.
Something about the name.
Something about the name, Jesus.
It's the sweetest name, yeah.
It is the sweetest name.
Sweetest name I know. Sweetest name, yeah.
It's the sweetest name.
Just take a minute and explain to him what you're really trying to say. What you're really trying to say.
Some people say I'm crazy, but
I can't explain.
I can't explain.
The power
that I feel
when you call his name.
When I call your name.
That fire.
Said it's just like fire.
Where's it?
Shut up in my mood.
Holy Ghost.
When the Holy Ghost gets a moving, said he won't leave me alone.
Clean up with us, y'all. Clean up with us. Everybody.
Something
about the name, Jesus.
Something about the name.
Something about the name.
It's the sweetest name, yeah.
It is the sweetest name.
Sweetest name I know. Wave at me if you love that name.
Oh, how I love the name, Jesus.
Oh, yeah, 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 yeah.
Oh, how I love the name, Jesus.
It's the sweetest name, yeah.
It is the sweetest.
How sweet is it?
Name.
I want you to tell Detroit for a minute. How sweet is it? Sweeter than honey.
Said it's sweeter than honey. From the honeycomb.
Yes, sir, yes, sir, yes, sir.
When the Holy Ghost gets to moving,
just won't leave you alone.
Said he won't leave me alone. Oh, no.
Now tell every Muslim, every Jew, at the name of Jesus.
At the name of Jesus.
What's going to happen someday?
Every knee has got to bow.
So tell them, don't wait.
You don't have to wait till the fire comes.
What can they do?
You can clap your hands
right
and praise
right
it now. Oh, yeah.
Detroit, let me hear you.
Yeah, yeah.
Something about the name, Jesus.
Something about that name.
Something about the name, Jesus.
It's the sweetest name.
I know.